I thank God that for a rainy day, we know it's a blessing from God. And Father, we thank you for this opportunity that we've gathered here, O God, to worship you in spirit and in truth. And thank you for guiding us, Lord, to this place safe, O God. And rejoice, Lord, with our all heart we have the opportunity to worship you, dear God. Lord, salamat, Lord, sa kapatayan na iyong binigay ko all the way. Thank you po sa kalusugan. Salamat po sa hope. Salamat po sa strength. And salamat po na sa inyong pagmamahal. And despite of everything that we're going through, oh God, sa mga nights, sa mga days na kami po ay hihirap at kami po ay napapagod, Lord God, every day you renew our strength. And there's no words to explain how we are grateful, O God, sa iyong pagpapala, O God, through us, O God. Lord, we may be weak, O God, but you shine through us, O God. Lord, we pray that you continue to use our lives as a living testimony, O God, as the light and salt of this earth, O God. And Lord, thank you for all the blessings. Thank you, God, for all the answered prayers. And we pray our family po na igabi po ang mag-ingat and mag-bless sa kanila, O God. Lord, we declare your goodness and faithfulness in our lives, O God. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. Okay, so let's remain standing. And let's keep this attitude of worship as we enter into the, you know, the worship time. We will be singing some songs that probably most of them you are already so familiar with. But let's give it unto the Lord. Like, let's not just utter the words, but let the words of the song be the prayers of our heart. Okay, so let's sing with Open the Eyes of My Heart.
I want to see you. Open your eyes. Open the eyes. Compassion is not the same as empathy or what we say altruism. You know, though the concepts are actually a bit related, pero iba po talaga siya. No? While empathy, okay, let's talk about it. Empathy, it refers more generally to our ability to take the perspective and the feel, like even the same feeling of that emotion of another person. That's empathy. Okay? Compassion, okay, is when those feelings and those thoughts include the desire to help. I can say, I really feel you. Oh, I know what you feel. But you don't do anything about that feeling. When you do and act on that feeling, that is compassion. See, the compassion of Christ is a regular theme in Matthew. You see in Matthew chapter 14, verse 14, you know, sabi doon, when Jesus went out to saw a great multitude, he was moved with compassion for them. Hindi lang siya na move sa with his compassion, what did he do is, they healed, Jesus Christ healed the sick. Right? Also, you can see in Matthew chapter 15, verse 32, ano yung nakalagay doon? At the time that he feeds the multitudes, sabi doon, now Jesus called his disciples to himself and said, I have compassion on the multitude because they have now continued with me 3 days and have nothing to eat. And I don't want to send them away hungry lest they faint on the way. So what happened here? After he's preaching on the mount, right? Multitude of people. Meron siyang compassion. Anong ginawa niya? Pinakain niya. Right? See how the Lord works here? You know, Jesus Christ is a Savior that is moved with compassion. As our Creator, Jesus knows our weaknesses as well. Don't tell the Lord that He don't know you. In fact, He knows you better than you know yourself. No? He knows our frustrations, our bouts with our depression. See, no? It's really hard to work with that kind of employer. Even though you love your employer, and yet your employer hurt you. Not only physically, even mentally. Right? Those kind of frustration, the Lord knows that. Sabi nga, di ba? Hindi ka nag-iisa. Kasama natin ang Diyos. Right? You know, He knows all the root cause of that every ill that we face. Either it is directly or indirectly linked to the fall of Adam and Eve on the Garden of Eden. Right? He knows. Though Jesus is not a soft Savior, kasi nga, compassionate, alam na siya, Savior, eh, di ba? But it doesn't mean that He is a soft Savior. By that, I mean that He has no room for those that make excuses for their sin. Or make excuses of what they have in that carnal reasons for not following Him. Lagi tayo may reason eh. Muna, Lord. Hindi mo lang ito ng church. Tapos, walang masakyan, Lord. Ang hirap maghanap ng sasakyan. Lalo na sa Philippines, you know, pag kayo wala sasakyan, ayaw na nila pumunta ng church. Right? Lalo na ngayon mainit. Nasanay kasi tayo sa tricycle, ano? Samantalang dito sa Hong Kong, you really have to walk. You know? Especially if yung, ang nangyari, yung position na pupuntahan mo, nasa kalagitnaan ng Bangkok at ng Yomate. Right? You really have to walk. It happens. And most of the time, the position of the churches are like that. But you know, let's go back. You know, He draws the line in the sand, Jesus Christ, when He discerns the impure, selfish motives. Why people cry out to Him. Remember that? But you know, God still cares to those who are poor in spirit. You know, even those people who are reeling under the weight of sin's debt and sin's burden, the Lord Jesus Christ is compassionate. You know, in the message that we have today, let's address this matter of compassion. I want to talk about what motivated the Lord Jesus Christ to be compassionate and how we can become more compassionate ourselves. Surely we need all the help in this area that we can get. But, you know, often we are so guilty of being selfish and self-centered. Very guilty. But you know, as a fellow follower of Christ, you and I need to be more like Jesus. Right? We have to be a Christ-like person, right? That's why we are Christians. Small Christ, Christian, hindi Christian. Yeah. Now let's look at the compassionate Savior today, and let's learn the secrets of for caring about those needs of others. The first, you know, let's talk about the origin of His compassion. You know, His compassion originated in His essence. How could Jesus reach out to the people He did? He, you know, or question of how could He care about so many different people with so many different problems? Another question about that, what motivated Him? You know, let's think for a moment about who Jesus is. He is a God in the flesh. I'm not saying he is fleshly, okay? What I meant is He is a God and also 100% man. 100% God, 100% man. So He is God in the flesh. He is not encumbered with a fallen nature. Kaya nga siya yung perfect sacrifice, right? He is not selfish, right? He is not self-centered. He transcends all the faults and flaws that mark humanity. Kaya nga ang hirap yung ginawang example ni Christ for us Christians to follow. Napakahirap kung ang flesh lamang natin ang gagawa. That's why we need the Holy Spirit within us to even be good to other person. We need the Holy Spirit within us to have that drive to come here in this church, rain or shine. Right? Kahit nga minsan, shining, medyo tinatamad ka pa rin pumunta eh. Diba? Anong reason? Ay, masyado kasi maliit yung lugar. Hindi kami kasya. Baka mamaya marami na sila doon. Hindi na lang ako pupunta. Diba? If we're thinking about that, all of you thinking about that, then that yes. Means only me will be here. You know, many people read Old Testament and come away with the idea that God is mean, that God is wrathful, that God is harsh. Yet, Jesus in the New Testament reveals the exact nature of God. You know, in John chapter 1 verse 18, ang sabi doon, no one has seen God at any time. The only begotten Son, who is in the bosom of the Father, He has declared Him.